It's Michelle of Lab Muffin Beauty Science, Chem PhD, cosmetic chemist, and sunscreen slapper honor. It's time for Asian sunscreen reviews. Some of these I've been asked about a lot, so it's kind of a relief to get these reviews out. These are all Korean and Japanese sunscreens that aren't approved in Western countries like Australia, except for the last one, which is actually a US sunscreen. What? Let's jump straight in with today's sponsor, SKIN1004. A lot of you have probably heard of them, but if you haven't, their Centella Ampoule is huge on Korean beauty apps. You might have also seen their zombie masks that make it look like you've really overdone it on those TikTok skincare hacks. More recently, you might have heard about their cleansing oil and their Waterfit Sun Serum. They actually have four sunscreens in their range, but this is the one that I hear the most about, and I can understand why. This is a really lightweight chemical sunscreen. It has four of those newer filters that stay more on the skin's surface, so there's less chance of irritation or potential health impacts. They also absorb UV better, so sunscreens can have a lighter texture while still giving really high protection. This is made by Colma, who made a lot of the really popular sunscreens that came out in the last couple of years, and it is a similar style of product. It has that really beautiful, smooth moisturizer texture that's just beautiful to apply and sits nicely under makeup. It glides on really smoothly like soft butter on your skin bread. This is even more lightweight than the ones I've reviewed before, like the Isntree and the Beauty of Chosen, so if you found those a bit heavy, then you'll probably like this one. It dries down to feel like almost nothing, but it's still giving that hydrating, slightly dewy finish. There's no white cast on medium skin tones, and there isn't any added fragrance. In terms of skincare actives, it's got centella and a whole bunch of plant extracts, hyaluronic acid, glycerin, and niacinamide. It's approved as a brightening and anti-wrinkle functional cosmetic in Korea. Alright, packaging connoisseur time. I love this pump top. You don't really see a lot of pump tops in Asian sunscreens, but I am a huge fan of them, even when they're not twisty tops.
The twisty top!
It just makes it so easy to apply a consistent amount, and you don't accidentally just keep on applying less and less over time without really noticing. Also, most importantly, the pump top is flat like the tube, so it doesn't actually take up extra space in my makeup bag. It looks round in a lot of the product photos, so I was actually kind of confused when it came in like a flat, standard Korean sunscreen box. I thought maybe I was thinking of the wrong product because I'm really unobservant, and that explains a lot of things in my life. I don't know why flat pump tops aren't more of a thing, this just makes so much sense to me. I also tried out the Tone Brightening Tone Up Sunscreen, which has the same packaging. Tone up sunscreens are a big thing in Asia, they basically leave a bit of a white cast on your skin on purpose to give a skin evening and brightening effect. It's like a tinted moisturizer that's a little bit lighter than your natural skin tone, it's sort of like the Asian equivalent of bronzer. This has mostly the same ingredient list as the Waterfit sunscreen, with extra titanium dioxide as well as some moisturizing ingredients. It feels a little bit heavier and richer, but it's still pretty lightweight. I do not have a good history with tone-up sunscreens. A lot of the time they make my skin look weirdly pink and detached from my neck. It's sort of like I'm having an allergic reaction. But this one is a lot more subtle. It actually did make my skin just look a little bit nicer and smoother. My skin tone looks more even, but it's still very natural with no weird pinkness after it dries down. It takes about 15 minutes though, so I spent a lot of time staring in the mirror going, Because tone-up sunscreens are essentially tinted products, you do have to apply them pretty evenly. This one is pretty forgiving even for an unobservant disaster like me. Sometimes I do get like a subtle white line here, but it blends out pretty easily without any pilling. So I am more open to tone-up sunscreens now. I've been using this when I don't want to go to the effort of putting on proper makeup, but I want my skin to look a bit nicer and I have the time to let it settle down and check for white marks before anyone sees me. The next sunscreen is the Kose? Suncut UV Perfect Essence Super Waterproof. Fun fact, this Japanese megacorp that I can't pronounce owns Tarte now. Suncut sunscreens are super popular and I've been recommended this so many times. If you're buying Suncut sunscreens, be really careful because a lot of them have similar names and packaging, so there is a gel version of this where it's also in a yellow tube and the only difference in the name is that essence is gel. This is a fragrance-free chemical sunscreen with mostly newer filters. It's designed for outdoor use, as you can probably tell from the super waterproof thing and the surfing goofy. This is a limited edition tube. I have to admit, I partly ordered it because of the goofy. If you want to hook me in, just put a face on the packaging. I probably won't be able to throw it out because it'll just look back at me out of the bin and I'll just feel really sad and guilty. It's also resistant to sweat and pollution. It has a little bit of a goopy texture and this nice water burst cooling effect when you rub it in. The cooling comes from alcohol, but I don't think it has that much because it doesn't really punch you in the nose like some sunscreens do. It doesn't sting my eyes, and I've seen a lot of people say this doesn't bother their skin as much as a lot of other sunscreens with alcohol. It's really hydrating with ingredients like hyaluronic acid, plant extracts, royal jelly extract, and collagen. This is the one sunscreen in this video that doesn't have niacinamide. If you're allergic to niacinamide, you must be having the worst time finding products, so this one is probably worth checking out. I thought this would be really shiny, but it isn't. After it dries down, it's actually quite matte and smooth and lightweight and not tacky. There's no white cast. But unfortunately, this does peel up on me. It kind of balls up in little tiny clear sandy grains. And this happened when I applied it on clean skin and also over products. On the bright side, the peeling isn't very visible, but the fact that it is coming off means that your sunscreen isn't really having that intact film anymore. You're getting less protection. From the reviews I've seen, it seems to really depend on your skin. There are lots of people who say it doesn't peel on them unless they're using the wrong products underneath. I'm guessing it's because I have oily skin, so it's just having a conscious uncoupling with my skin oil. It probably works better if you have dry skin. I think this is one of those sunscreens where if it doesn't ball up on your skin, then it's going to be one of your favorites, but I am not one of Kose's chosen ones. Here is another lightweight Colmar sunscreen. It's the Benton AirFit UV Defense Sun Cream. This is pretty much exactly the same as the Beauty of Chosen sunscreen. They have really similar ingredient lists and I tested them side by side. I could not tell the difference between them in terms of texture, feel, how they apply, and how they look on my skin. The differences are this has a minty scent that comes from rosemary essential oil and it looks green coming out of the tube. I originally thought this was giving a cooling effect because it does say cooling, but then I tried the Beauty of Chosen one and it felt exactly the same going on, so I think it's just the water evaporating and maybe a bit of a psychological effect with that minty smell. I was also hoping that the green color would help neutralize some of the redness on my skin, but it doesn't. I think it's just too faint to make any difference. The skincare actors in this have a sort of soothing, calming theme. It has centella and licorice extract. As nice as this is, it has a bunch of claims that just make me feel a bit ugh. First off, they go on about how the ingredients are EWG green grade, which means they're rated safe on the EWG's very arbitrary made up scale. If toned-out sunscreens are like here on my sus rankings, then the EWG is like... Yeah, I do not like the EWG. They say it's free from octinoxate, but then they don't say what's so bad about octinoxate. They say it's free from silicones, but then it has two silicones right there in the ingredients list. The silicones are probably a big reason why it feels so nice and it looks so good under makeup. Just please show some respect for the silicones. They say it's blue light protection tested, but they don't give any details about it, so it's been tested, but did it do well in the test? Like, can you share the results with us, please? I'm not really seeing anything in the ingredients list that's an obvious blue light protector. The other similar Colmar sunscreens don't have blue light claims. They also have this brand tagline that says they make non-chemical products, which is obviously really silly because everything is chemicals, but especially silly because this carefully says it has organic UV filters, but then on the website it says it's a chemical sunscreen. I'm guessing they did that because so many people ask them what organic means, is it chemical or physical, and they got sick of answering, but then they had to put chemical on the same website where they say their products are non-chemical. Price-wise, it's also very similar to the Beauty of Chosen sunscreen, so I would just go for that unless you're like allergic to rice. This sunscreen is a little bit different. It is Glow Recipe's Watermelon Glow Niacinamide Sunscreen. Yes, before anyone yells at me, Glow Recipe is a US brand, but they have Korean-American founders and they have like a very K-beauty vibe. Their products have lightweight textures, they've got a strong focus on hydration, this cute fruit theme. They've also got actives that are very popular in Korean products, like the one that starts with N and ends in niacinamide. This launch was really exciting to me because it's an Asian-style sunscreen that's actually approved in the US and stocked in Sephora, so people in the US can actually go and try the sunscreen before buying it and not have to wait for shipping or worry about fake products. The downside of a US sunscreen is that their sunscreen ingredient options are a bit needs improvement. So it was really great to see Glow Recipe take on this challenge of trying to make a US approved sunscreen that actually feels nice and lightweight. I really, really wanted to like this, but it did the one thing that is like a complete deal breaker for me. It peeled up on my skin pretty badly and the peeling was very visible. It was very like white and grey. This sunscreen does not peel on everyone. There are lots of people who love this, but it does seem to peel up on a good portion of people. I tried so hard to make this work. I tried it on bare skin right after washing. I tried it after 15 minutes, after an hour. Then I saw on TikTok someone say that it worked on their skin after they moisturized it really well. So I tried it over 6 different products with really different formulas and it didn't work. So by that point, I was pretty depressed and I gave up. Every time I tried it, it was fine when I first put it on, but then after it set, after maybe about 5-10 minutes, if I even brushed against it, then it would peel and you could really, really see those pills. I don't know if it's like my skin or the humidity here in Sydney or just some other curse. I'm sure there's some product out there that would stop this from peeling on me, but I have not found it and I am too sad to keep going. I'm also the sort of person who puts on makeup right before leaving the house, so if a sunscreen peels a lot, then it is probably not going to work with my extreme lifestyle. Otherwise, this is pretty nice. It's not really as lightweight as the Asian sunscreens I've been trying, but considering that it does only use US filters, I think they did really well. There was some white cast, but not as much as I expected for an untinted sunscreen with 12% zinc oxide. It is a bit shiny, but dewy skin is sort of part of Glow Recipe's brand, and it is actually quite hydrating, which is pretty impressive. Again, there is 12% zinc in this. I love that they did this, but I would recommend trying a sample on your own skin before buying the full tube because who it peels on seems to be a bit all over the place. I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know what else you want me to try. Click the like and subscribe to tell YouTube you want to watch more of my videos, and more reviews are popping up around me.